Katy Perry's been on the durries. Okay, unemployment has hit record levels in some parts of Australia, and it's particularly bad if you are young. As this map shows, it's more than 20% in some places. Wow. So how do you stop your child ending up on the dole queue? Well, Dr. Jim Bright is a career specialist and he joins us on the panel now. Jim, good morning to you.
Good morning.
What's going on with these numbers? Why are we seeing unemployment rates so high?
I think one of the simplest answers is jobs are becoming more skilled. So people need skills to get into work. And employers are also insisting on experience. So if you want skills and you want experience, they're the two things very often school leavers don't have. You leave school, you maybe don't have the qualifications, or if you do have the qualifications, you don't have the experience. So it creates a trap.
Mm. Now, this is the ultimate catch-22 that we've been talking about since time began. Mm. How do you get the experience if you can't get the job? And how do you get the job if you can't get the experience? Are there ways that young people can get their foot in the door?
Yeah, I mean, the best way of doing it is networking. About 82% of people find jobs through their networks, not through job advertisements. Mm. So it's a mistake. If you're only applying for the jobs you see online or the jobs you see advertised in the paper or down at Centrelink or what have you, then, you know, you've reduced your chances by, you know, a huge amount of finding work. So using a network is incredibly important. And the point is, everybody has got a network. It's not just something that sort of powerful and rich people have. Everybody has a network if they think about the people, you know, that they may work with, the people who they see on a daily basis, the people in the local club, the people who are known in their communities.
But so, before we get to the network, you know, I often think too much pressure is put on kids when they're at school. They have to decide when they're quite young what they want to be.
Yes.
And, you know, when they get to the end of their school days, a lot of their thoughts have changed. So how does a parent actually prepare the child, to study the right subjects according to the child's ability and not making the kid do something that they really are not equipped to do?
You've got to be talking to your child regularly and be connected with your school, get some feedback from the school on what subjects the child's doing well in, what they enjoy doing. And don't lock people into this. This crazy question, what do you want to be when you grow up, is awful. I mean, one of my heroes is Peter Ustinov, the actor, who said on his 75th birthday, I really must decide what to do with my life. and I think, you know, that is quite a good philosophy, to be open and flexible, because we don't know what jobs are going to be around. Mm. We don't know what courses are necessarily going to be in demand in 10 or 15 years' time. So playing that guessing game and locking yourself too early into doing something, people change. And we've found that in the research that we've done, 18 months after you leave school, over half of school leavers have changed their interests. If they've done any courses, they've dropped out or changed courses. If they've done apprenticeships, they've changed apprenticeships. Over half of them have done it. So if we focus too much early on about what exactly you're going to be, you're basically creating inflexibility, and employers are crying out for a flexible workforce. Mm.
And Jim, also, you know, a lot of kids now have just finished their higher education, wondering what to do, and their parents might be worried about, oh, they haven't got any motivation.
Yep.
How can I encourage them?
Yep.
And how can I point them in those directions? What's your advice?
There's a range of things to do. Firstly, model good approaches to work. So, you know, coming home from work and complaining, oh, I've had a hell of a day today and it's been awful. Well, your kids are listening to this. Mm. And what are they picking up? That work is an awful thing that you have to do. So you need to be able to say, I love my job. You don't have to be completely unrealistic about it, but you need to leaven the complaints with the sort of, yeah, I get these rewards. I enjoy this aspect of it. It allows me to live the life that I want to live. So modelling that is really important. And as I've already mentioned, networks. And if you're a parent, use your networks to help your child. Mm. For instance, bring them to work with you if you can. Mm. Get them to shadow people at work or go in to see some of your friends and go into work in those sort of places as well. So, again, networking is so important here, as well as modelling good work attitudes.
And work experience, I suppose, because you can be overeducated and still not get that job. Jim Bright, thank you very much for joining us this morning. Do appreciate it.
My pleasure.